Hello everyone, welcome back to the Indie Geek Guy channel. Hope you're well. Back with some more Hannibal time. So last time on Hannibal we had a bit of a breathing episode, an episode that focused around Abigail waking out of her coma, the fallout of that, how the people around her are reacting to everything that's happened. Some people think she's guilty along with her father, mainly Jack, one of her other main characters, but also it seems like the town that she's in are all against her, just writing cannibals across her house, just everything that's going bad. Everything that could go bad is going bad for her at this point. But right at the end of the episode, she killed a scraggly gingerhead guy who was the brother of one of the victims, and now Hannibal has helped her out. Done her solid by hiding the body and putting the blame elsewhere to keep the scent off of him and off of Abigail, and kind of manipulated her into thinking that, hey, if you come clean about this, no one's going to believe you. Everyone's going to think you're part of this whole cannibal ring even more than they already do. So, you know what? Trust me. Trust me. All the while, Will is still suffering from some nightmares. He's really putting himself in the shoes of Abigail's dad. Like, he has a connection with her because he feels like he himself tried to kill her, seemingly. And he's kind of, trying to make up for that, trying to be a protector to Abigail because of that mind space that he's occupying. And can he trust himself? Is Hannibal is manipulating effects and stuff that's going on in his head. So yeah, that's what we're doing. So yeah, we're just rolling along with this plot line, and yeah, we'll see how this all progresses in this next episode, if Abigail and Hannibal's pact maintains, or if there's going to be cracks, or what's going to be happening with that. Also, we've got Freddy shit stirring just stirring the barrel just to get a scoop, get them scoops. And all the while in the middle, we've got Alana Bloom just trying to talk sense to everyone and feels like nobody's listening. That's where we're at with everyone, more or less. But before we jump into this episode, remember to hit the thumbs up button if you enjoy the reaction and the review of the episode that happens afterwards. Also consider subscribing, supporting the channel. That way you won't miss any future videos. That's more reactions to Hannibal, that's gameplay videos, that's reviews, all that fun stuff. Make sure you're doing that if you do enjoy the content. There is also social links down below if you're interested in that stuff. There's also a Discord server, so go hang out over there, talk to other people, build up the community, good stuff all around. But that's it. Everything said, everything done. Let's jump into the next episode of Hannibal.
You could sense his madness, like a bloodhound.
I tried so hard to know Garrett Jacob Hobbs.
How did you feel seeing Marisha Shaw impaled in his outer room?
Guilty. Because I felt like I killed her.
Yeah, he's very much struggling with that. Feeling guilty for everything at the minute.
Sometimes I felt like we were doing the same things at different times of day.
Like you were becoming him.
I know who I am.
Oh, well. Slippery slope. I'm legitimately, like, sweaty palms about where Will could end up going. Not good. Maggots! Maggots everywhere! Pendulum time. Interrupting a roast dinner like that? That's criminal.
I brought my own family to this home invasion, controlling the Turners with threats of violence.
The Turner family is executed simultaneously, with the exception of Mrs. Turner. I shoot Mrs. Turner.
So some sort of angry relative is what I'm going with. I put money down right now. Angry relative. Watch the episode, twist it, and be something completely different. Or just not even matter. It might not even matter. It's just another case of for Will to get itself lost further down the rabbit hole in. I'm assuming it's safe to just assume that any meat that Hannibal might have on him is probably human, right? Just, you know, a safe bet in general. Okay, Hannibal's up to no good, as always. Good to know.
A son, Jesse, disappeared last year. Last confirmed sighting had him boarding an RV. Possible runaway, probable abduction.
Or both. Shooter went low to high, probably crouching.
When was Jesse abducted?
A little over a year ago.
But I don't have a home anymore, do I? You will. You will. I'll help you find it.
God bless Alana Bloom, the paragon of this show.
Spending each day immersed in tragedy may be doing more harm than good. She should be out in the world, finding her footing, giving her the confidence to move forward.
I feel that's probably what Hannibal did. I don't know what the backstory for this version of Hannibal is, but I'm fairly sure the Hannibal from the movies had a fairly tragic, beginning.
I thought middles were the problem.
Middle's the sweet spot.
Always trying to figure out where they fit in.
There's forgiveness.
What kind of victim forgives the killer at the moment of death?
A mother? Just maybe?
A mother?
It scares me how often me and Will are on the same page.
Both my parents died when I was very young.
There it is.
The proverbial orphan until I was adopted by my uncle Robertus when I was 16. Did your family have money, Will?
We were poor. I followed my father from the boatyards of Biloxi and Greenville to lake boats on Erie.
Always the new boy at school, always the stranger.
A modified Boudin Noir from Alibab's Gastronomie Pratique.
Man, he is just. He's just giving Jack.
Well, we're gonna have to polish up our act.
All the human food.
He should have hopped faster.
Yes, he should have.
Yeah. About that. Where is this going? You keep feeding Jack human meat. That has to be going somewhere.
Will may feel the tug of life before the FBI, before you. Simpler times in boatyards with Dad. That life is an anchor streamed behind him in heavy weather.
So we're getting a lot about Will's sort of childhood and what makes him feel safe in this episode, and it seems to be tied to boat and the life of shipyards and stuff. Which I have a vague memory from Red Dragon. Didn't he have a boat in that? Maybe?
Is that unusual?
Well, they sort of hinted at it.
Okay, class dismissed. Everyone out. What did I just say? Let's go!
I love Angry Jack. Lord Tishburne just kills it every time.
We found a match to a set of prints we pulled from the Turner home. They belonged to a 13-year-old boy from Reston, Virginia.
You're expecting a crime scene.
Christmas. It's Christmas. I'm willing to bet this is going to be the best, most happy Christmas. Oh. Yep. Santa came to town, all right, that's for sure. Oh my god, what the fuck? Excuse me?
Her body went into convulsions.
Shot her again. Put her out of her misery. Different gun.
So someone else shot Connor's mom.
So who? Someone herding these kids? Divorce. Someone herding them?
He'd been prepped to shoot his mother, not watch her suffer.
Connor couldn't put his panic back into bottles, so he got shot too.
Someone is collecting kids and getting them to kill their mothers. Or entire families, specifically.
The family you're born into isn't really family. Those are just people you didn't choose. You have to make family. That's what we're doing. We're making our family.
Interesting that we're dealing with our main character's family and we've got makeshift family killer team. So the oldest kid is just fully indoctrinated by the looks of it. This kid's peed himself. Is it because he's so scared of the kid? It felt like he looked at the older kid and got frightened.
I'm angry about those boys. I'm angry because I know when I find them, I can't help them. I can't give them back what they just gave away. We call them the lost boys.
Abigail's lost too.
Good movie.
Then perhaps it's our responsibility, yours and mine, to help her find her way.
Is he just going to use Abigail's way to get to Will? I don't know what it feels like.
I don't think I'm allowed.
Finding a common ground.
I thought you might enjoy if I cooked for you.
Oh, God. Here we go. Here we go.
Even though she's dead, I'm afraid that Marissa's going to tell everyone I killed him and they'll think I'm just like my dad. Can't really talk about this in group.
You don't have that luxury, Abigail.
Hannibal's just pulled all the strings, so everyone just relies on him. That's what's happened.
Does that make me a sociopath?
No. It makes you a survivor.
So that's how Hannibal probably sees himself, based on his growing up. If his growing up is exactly how I remember it being in the other version, the movie.
I want to work for the FBI.
I would certainly feel safer if you were in the FBI.
Oh my God, that double meaning. Jesus.
I have all the access to traumatic memories I need. Unlimited access.
Which is why we need to supplement them with positive associations.
You want me to do drugs?
I want you to do this with my subordinate.
Is this a legal practice, Hannibal? Is this legal? I mean, I think based on his other actions, it's probably the least illegal thing. But he is drugging a kid at the same time.
Sausage and eggs was the last meal I was having with my parents.
I know.
He's doing this by design.
It's also the first meal you're having with me.
Trying to create a new association with a father figure.
Whoever this woman is, she wants these children to burst with love for her. But she has to erase their family to do that.
Kind of what Hannibal's doing right this second, guys. In his own way. Not quite. Kind of reverse order.
He was with an unidentified woman.
Where's this kid's parents?
Fayetteville, North Carolina.
Oh, I'm nervous. Oh, I'm so nervous. Hopefully this kid is different. Hopefully. Oh my God, they got there in the nick of time. Fuck me. Oh my God.
She wasn't ready to leave the hospital. She experienced a bit of anxiety, so I gave her a sedative.
Right, a sedative. What did you get? A sedative. This is all planned by Hannibal, like to, again, reassociate family members for Abigail.
Hannibal made breakfast for dinner. I could eat.
Breakfast for dinner is a great thing, though. It is a great thing. Yep, there it is.
What do you see?
There it is.
I see family.
This is worrisome. This is a little bit worrisome. Oh shit. It's fucking Firefly. Fuck. Name. Gone from brain.
Think it's too late for us to have kids?
It is for me.
Well, that looks like something that's going to be unpacked as we go along. There it is. Back into his nightmare world. All right, another episode down. A lot of family values being the theme here. Lots of how does one feel about their family and can a family be built from the ground up or... what? All of that stuff. All of the family stuff. So once again, we had the procedural element of the episode was directly linked into our main characters and their stuff. So obviously here we had a mother who had kidnapped kids to form her own family and kind of brainwash them into believing that their real family is not their real family, that they can be a part of something else. Basically cult-like. Sort of a cult-like, right? One of those kids had taken to it a great deal and had, like, completely morphed. Like, they were saying he seemed like a model kid. Like, he was perfectly healthy, perfectly good, no problems whatsoever, and it looked like he had been changed into the worst of the bunch by the end of it. So we had all that going on with these kids being manipulated, so then the most direct reference from that was Hannibal shifting the gears in Abigail's head, trying to get her to associate him as a father figure or at least a family member, and then at the end we had him using Abigail, knowing she would show up to be the mother figure. I kind of feel like he wants that to be Will, but he's playing the game of it's going to be easier to get it to be Alana first and to set that dynamic up and then shift the gears again into maybe getting it to be Will, because Hannibal just seems fascinated by Will, everything that's going on with his brain. He likes kind of pushing him and torturing him just to see what he'll do and how he'll respond to it. But yeah, there's, you know, something's definitely building there. But overall, this episode, it just made me feel awful for all the kids, including Abigail, in this in this whole thing as it unraveled. Like, God, disturbing. Like, I was going to say that this episode, you know, this episode's pretty slow. It's pretty chill compared to the other episodes so far. Even compared to the last episode, which was pretty slow and just unveiling things. But then I remembered there was a lot of, like, dead families and kids killing their families and... yeah, that's pretty intense. But no, it was like a slow burn as this whole thing was being unraveled, and it had a lot of complex things it was trying to get across, so I appreciated that slow burn and just slowly revealing the details. And obviously, like, they also tapped into not just the direct thing of what Hannibal was doing right here, right now, in relation to building families, changing people's minds into making them feel what their actual family is versus what their actual real family is, but also tapping into both Hannibal and Will's childhoods. Like, we got little bits of information about them, about Will following his dad around shipyards and constantly moving schools, always being the outsider. We also got a hint that maybe he might have been the middle child in his family. It's not directly said, but it feels like he understood the plight of a middle child a lot more than what everybody else in that group was saying when they were talking about it. But then also we got a little bit of a hint towards Hannibal's past. Obviously, I feel like in the movies that I know, if I'm remembering correctly, he had a pretty hard, like his parents were killed in front of him, I believe, or something along those lines, and he had to survive the outcome of that, and he ended up, that's sort of how he became a cannibal, if I'm remembering correctly, because of that, how that played out. And yeah, like, I can't remember all the details of it from the movies at all, but it was something like that, and it seems like we're hinting towards something like that here, not giving away too many details. I don't know if they're ever going to give away the whole backstory of him or keep it kind of mysterious, and, like, you can read into it how you're going to read into it, but I definitely felt like we were doing that journey, especially with the, you know, as I was saying, the episode being about, like, making a family out of someone who isn't technically your family. But we also got Hannibal talking to Abigail, like, hey, this makes you a survivor. And it felt like it was him saying it kind of to himself. Like, hey, you don't have to regret this. You just had to do what you had to do in order to survive. And that's how it is. And that's life. And, you know, we're the same kind of thing. That was the vibe I was getting off of that moment. Obviously, he wasn't being direct, but it felt like that's what he was trying to get across. But yeah, this episode did consist of a lot of therapy sessions between various characters, mainly Will and Hannibal. They were talking quite a lot about certain things, about how Will was feeling about what has happened and what is currently happening. We got a much more overt Will actually talking about how he feels about being in the shoes of these killers that he studies and thinks, and how he went the extra mile with Hobbs and how that's affected him. Like, it was like a step beyond what he would normally do. Like, he tried so hard to understand this guy, not just from what he was reading about him, but actively, very much emotionally tying himself to him. And, you know, it's put him in that way, which I kind of suspected from the beginning. It's definitely that was coming across, but we actually had Will admitting it, saying it out loud, not to the right person, because Hannibal's obviously going to use that in some way, but, you know, he said it out loud at least, I guess, and we'll go from there with that. I also feel really bad for Alana Bloom, because she's being manipulated. By the end of this episode, it's, oh God, I felt so horrible for her, because she's such, like, the knight in shining armor in this show. She's doing everything she can to keep people safe and to make sure things are being done properly, and we're looking after people in the right way. And, you know, Hannibal is just, you know, just like, well, I kind of need you to be doing this, so I'm going to kind of just push things over here, and you're not going to be none the wiser. It's just awful. I can't. It's going to be some shit when this falls in on itself, because it has to at some point. Like, this has to come collapsing down in some sort of spectacular way, and that's going to be a thing. Didn't get any Freddy this episode, which is interesting, because it feels like, you know, kids killing their families would be like something she would be jumping off on. Like, I can get a story out of this, no problem whatsoever. And I can use Will and that what's going on with him and Abigail. And like, it feels like a thing she would jump on, but who knows? Maybe it might come about in the next episodes. Who knows? But yeah, not here in this one. Talking about how this episode felt a bit like more of a slower burn, even though the previous episode was a quieter episode, it still felt quite intense in how it was being shot and filmed. This one seemed to have more of a relaxed sort of pace to it. And I don't know, even as I say, we're dealing with quite a lot of murders in this episode. And yet the direction was only super intense in that first therapy session and like the reveal of the family at the dinner table. Then after that, it kind of got a bit like we're just kind of washing with it. Like, you know, I mean, I guess that maybe was by design since they were talking about boats a lot and like where Will feels safe in his head when he can sort of imagine the boat and the sea and all that stuff. So maybe probably by design to have that kind of feel in how the episode was being directed. We also got Jack, a bit more personal info on Jack. He had a little chat with the kid there at the end and talked about how he hasn't got any kids, and we got to see his partner wife, I assume, who's Zoe from Firefly. Is that right? I think I've got that right. It's been a while since I watched Firefly, but asking if they can have kids and got the cold shoulder right there and then. So something is happening there that is going to be unpacked, I'm sure, and maybe it'll lead us to sort of maybe understand why Jack is maybe got some anger issues, because we got another anger display from him this episode. So yeah, that's going to be interesting. And we're obviously continuing the idea of Hannibal feeding Jack human meat, which, you know, he's been doing that to a few people, but he seems to be targeting Jack for some reason. Like, he seems very specific in those meals with him, and it feels like that's definitely going somewhere, which, who knows where, but it definitely feels like there's a thing of that. So yeah, this episode seemed to be just largely about pushing the boat forward, no pun intended, in terms of where Will is at, in terms of his connection with these killers, how that's affecting him, but also pushing sort of the plot forward with the Abigail and Hannibal relationship and where that's going to go. Tragedy is the only thing I see in these people's future. That's it. And obviously I don't know how close to the movies and the books, of course, which, I mean, I've not read the books, but I don't know how close the show is going to be going with that, if we're going to get into a point where we're kind of remaking those stories, or if we've been doing that all along. Because again, I've not read the book, so I don't know what specific elements other than the characters that have been taken from the books, but I don't know, it's interesting. But I assume there's going to be a point where they discover Hannibal's true nature and how that's going to come about, and if they're going to change why and how that happens. But it feels like there's more of a longer story at play that they're going to be sort of muddling that up maybe a little bit, but who knows. I am looking forward to how all of this stuff that is being built up is going to come to that point of everything crossing, people discovering stuff about people that they don't want to know, probably, or they do want to know, but it's going to change everything, and how that will affect the show going forward. So yeah, it's another stepping stone to that event happening, and oh boy, it's going to be a thing. Overall, enjoy this episode. Had some interesting themes. I liked how those themes played both out literally in terms of the procedural side of the crime, the criminal element that was going on and being investigated alongside with the characters, and how those themes spoke to them and what they've been through, what they're currently going through. Boy, it's very well done and well balanced between the two, because at no point was I more or less interested in either side of that coin. I was just as invested in the crime that was happening and how they were investigating it, whilst also being just as invested in how those themes are playing out with our main characters and obviously the Abigail story going forward and all of that stuff. So yeah, solid episode. Enjoyed it a lot. Can't wait to keep on going. Thank you for watching this one, guys. If you enjoyed it, please press the thumbs up button. It helps me know you liked it. It helps it get seen by more people. All that good stuff. Also consider subscribing and supporting the channel. But other than that, thank you for watching. I'll catch you on the next one.